Once again, good morning, everyone. I think we waited enough for participants who wish to join our webinar today. Once again, welcome on this webinar on Pan-African Forest Certification for the Congo Basin. Please be advised that the meeting will be recorded and will be put on the PEFC website as part of the public consultation process for the assessment and endorsement of this scheme. Our program today will be a short introduction about PEFC International, which will be followed by the presentation on the Pan-African Forest Certification for the Congo Basin, including a welcome message from the included countries, and then for the project coordinator, detailed presentation. And at the end of the webinar, you will have the possibility to ask clarification questions, and then the answers will be provided by the project coordinator. To start with, PEFC stands for Program for the Endorsement of Forest Certification Systems. We are an alliance of independent national forest certification systems under the umbrella of PEFC International. The national forest certification scheme is based on PEFC's sustainability benchmark standards. This voluntary mechanism promotes sustainable forest management through independent third-party certification. We are the world's largest forest certification system and provider of 3/4 of the world's certified sustainably managed wood. Here you can see a map of the distribution of the members and the covered hectares. Currently, we have 55 national members with 48 endorsed certification systems covering 320 million hectares of forest. With this very brief introduction, we arrived to the PAFC, which is very similar to PEFC, but this stands for the Pan-African Forest Certification for the Congo Basin. The scheme is adopted by 3 countries, Cameroon, Congo, Republic of, and Gabon. The system was submitted in 2020 December for assessment and endorsement. This assessment will be carried out by an independent assessor yet to be appointed. And the assessment includes a 60-day public consultation, which opened today. You can reach the public consultation platform on the PEFC website and also through this link. This public consultation, you will have time to access the full documentation of the scheme and provide comments. So today's webinar, you can have the questions for clarifications, but for in-depth commenting and opinion submission, you will have the 60 days available during this public consultation. All these comments will be submitted on this online platform, including the question and answers for this webinar, will be considered by the assessor in the assessment report. And with this very brief introduction, we arrived already to the second part of the webinar program, and I will stop sharing my screen. And I will ask my colleague Thomas to share his screen and start to deliver the message to the presidents of the involved countries. Thank you.
Mesdames et messieurs, bonjour. Je suis Rose Ondo. Je suis la présidente de PAFC Gabon. Je suis docteur en sociologie et expert en ingénierie sociale du développement durable. PFC Gabon est l'organisation pionnière de la certification forestière sur le continent africain. PAFC Gabon a été créé en 2004 et est devenu la même année le premier membre de PEFC Council sur le continent africain. En 2009, PEFC Council reconnaît le schéma de certification forestière développé par PAFC Gabon. En 2014, PAFC Gabon révise son schéma qui est à nouveau reconnu par PEFC Council. En 2018, la société forestière Precious Wood devient la première entité à être certifiée PAFC Gabon. Aujourd'hui, PAFC Gabon a certifié plus de 500 000 hectares de forêt et 2 chaînes de contrôle au Gabon. PFC Gabon ne voudrait pas en rester là. C'est pour ça que PFC Gabon s'est engagé récemment avec 2 autres membres de PFC Council en Afrique, à savoir le PFC Cameroun et le PFC Congo, pour développer le schéma régional, sous-régional de certification forestière dénommé PFC Bassin du Congo. Ce schéma est actuellement soumis à PEFC pour sa reconnaissance. Nous espérons qu'à l'automne 2021, ce schéma sera reconnu par PEFC Conseil.
Bonsoir à la très grande famille PEFC International. Bonne année à vous et à vos différentes familles. Je suis Reine Edwige Andjembe, la présidente de PAFC Cameroun depuis avril 2017. Le PAFC est un système camerounais de certification qui atteste la bonne gestion forestière ainsi que de la traçabilité des bois et des produits forestiers issus des forêts gérées durablement. Créé en octobre 2007, le PAFC est membre de la grande famille PEFC International en novembre de la même année. Et depuis 2011, le PAFC Cameroun a lancé le processus de mise en place de son système. Et avec persévérance, dur labeur et espoir, nous avons finalement obtenu notre certificat de reconnaissance par PEFC International le 12 novembre 2019. Enfin, le PAFC Cameroun s'est engagé dans le processus de mise en place du PAFC Bassin du Congo, qui nous espérons est en bonne voie de reconnaissance. Je vous remercie.
Greetings from Republic of Congo. Je suis Brice-Séverin Pongui, avocat de profession, président du bureau exécutif de PAFC Congo, une association que vous connaissez sans doute, la dernière des associations créées donc, pour participer à la mise en place d'un schéma de certification dans la sous-région. Notre organisation a été créée le 26 janvier 2017 et nous sommes devenus par la suite membres de PEFC International le 1er juin 2017. Depuis, nous avons par la suite rejoint l'initiative par ce bassin du Congo parce que nous avons compris le message qui nous invitait à nous associer à d'autres PAFC, donc PAFC Gabon, PAFC Cameroun, pour pouvoir mutualiser nos efforts afin de mettre en place un schéma qui soit vraiment efficace et accepté par les parties prenantes. Et nous sommes donc très heureux de faire partie de cette communauté, une communauté qui travaille pour la gestion durable des forêts du bassin du Congo. Et à ce sujet, je donne la parole donc à M. Germain Yéné, qui va sans doute vous présenter le contexte de gestion durable des forêts dans le bassin du Congo. Merci pour votre bonne attention. Allô. Allô.
On t'entend, Germain.
We can hear you, Germain, now. Please proceed with the presentation.
Okay. Thank you, Hubert, for giving me the floor. And hi to everyone participating on this webinar. As you said, my name is Yenny Germain. I am coordinating the PFC Congo Basin Certification Scheme Project. And my presentation this morning will be focused on a brief summary of the process of elaboration of the PFC Congo Basin Certification Scheme. And to do that, I will go through three main points, let's say like that. The first point is about the context in the Congo Basin. And the second point is about the process of forest standard development itself. And the third point will be about the some generalities concerning the scheme, the system that we are putting in place. I don't know, can you see the slides? Because it looks
your
like
first slide, Chairman.
Sorry, seems like I have a small problem. Okay. Hello.
Hello. Yes, we can see your PowerPoint now.
Okay. Thank you. And so I was saying that my presentation will be down to two main points. The first point concerns the context in the Congo Basin forest. The second point is about the process of the forest standard setting. And the third point concerns the presentation of some components of the system that we are putting in place. So concerning the first point, the objective of this point is to present briefly the general context in which the certification operation will be implemented. So at least it is important to understand that general context because it can help understand other things after. So concerning the Congo Basin forest, as you all know, we are here in a humid tropical forest, which is the second largest humid tropical forest in the world after Amazonia. And the superficie of the Congo Basin forest is estimated at nearly 200 million hectares, covering six countries, namely Cameroon, Congo Republic, Equatorial Guinea,
Gabon, Central African Republic, and DRC. And as you can see on the map here, the forest in the Congo Basin is represented in green here. And you can see that more than 50% of the Congo Basin forest is located in DRC. You can see DRC here. And concerning the usage of that forest land, we can say that we have, in terms of usages of the forest land in the Congo Basin, we have agriculture, which is practiced by small farmers, and also and more international corporation dealing with agro-industry commodities. For example, we have plantations on rubber, palm oil, tea, cocoa, and so on. And also, we have forest activities going on in the Congo Basin forest also. We have protected areas. Here we can mention the parks for the conservation of the fauna, and also the forest reserves, because in some country you have forest reserves which have been put in place for many purposes. And in those forest reserves, we are including the forest concessions where logging operations are taking place, because those concessions are considered as a forest reserve. And finally, we have mining activities. And mining activities are spreading very, very rapidly in the Congo Basin forest. And now, concerning the legal framework in the Congo Basin, the laws governing the logging operations in the Congo Basin, I would like to mention or to underline 4 points here. The first point is that in the Congo Basin, most of the forestry laws are relatively similar from a country to another. And the second thing is that as far as the forest title used to do logging operation are concerned, we can also note that most of the forest title are similar in the different countries in the Congo Basin also. And the process of the attribution or awarding of those forest titles is also similar, because in the different countries, you can see that forest concessions, for example, even some other forest titles, most of those forest titles are awarded through a tender process. And also on the ground, we can see that most of the operations, logging operations, I mean, are very similar from a country to another and from a logging company to another. So I think this is also an important thing to have in mind. And concerning certification in the Congo Basin, first of all, I think I would mention that logging operations in the region are taking place according to OFAC. Logging operations are taking place in nearly 50 million hectares for now in the Congo Basin. And from those 50 million hectares, 32 million are being managed with forest management plans approved or validated by forest administrations in each country. And from the 50 million hectares, we have nearly 10 million hectares certified under different certification scheme. Sustainable certification and also legal certification. And concerning the certification of legality, nearly 4.5 million hectares are certified under this type of certification, representing 45%. And sustainable forest management certification represent 5.5 million hectares, representing 55% of the 10 million hectares certified. And in those superficies certified, and mainly the superficies certified under the sustainable forest management, as Rose from Gabon mentioned at the beginning, we have one concession certified under PFC Gabon certification scheme in Gabon, and it represents around 11% of the total superficie certified under sustainable forest management certification. And now, the 50 million hectares that I have just mentioned, where logging operations are taking place, that superficie is divided, let's say, in two big forest domains. We have the permanent forest estate, where most of the concessions, forest concessions, which are certified, are located. So all the forest concessions certified under sustainable forest management in Congo Basin are located in what we call permanent forest estate. And we also have a non-permanent forest domain where the rest of the forest title awarded in the region are located. And in that domain, for the moment, according to the requirements, it will be difficult, or it is difficult to have to certify logging operation there. Why? Just because one of the requirements to go to the certification is to have a management plan in place. In those areas, in that domain, forest domain, non-permanent forest domain, the forest management plan is not a requirement. So for sustainable forest certification, it will be almost impossible to certify a forest title there because of the missing of the forest management plan. And concerning the species which are logged in the Congo Basin, I can say that we have, let's say, around 33 species which are currently and regularly logged in the region. And most of those 30 species are present in the different countries in the Congo Basin. Even if for some species, we can mention some specificity. There are some species which are very located. For example, what we call okume. The scientific name is Okumea clanea. That species is mainly found in Gabon. Whereas you can find some small areas with that species in Congo Republic and at the extreme south of Cameroon. And concerning log exportation, Gabon in the region, Gabon has banned log exportation since some years now. Even if there are also some countries which banned log exportation some years ago, for example, in Cameroon, where since 1999, the exportations of logs of the main tree species exported have been banned since that year. It represents around 15 to 20 species which are prohibited for log exportation from Cameroon. And according to a communique issued or published last year, the countries of the Congo Basin are intending to extend the log export ban, the total log export ban in the region, maybe from this year or next year. I don't know exactly the date. And now, concerning the second main point, which concerns the standard setting process, process itself, I would mention at the beginning that I think Hubert said that when he presented the PFC, the current PFC Congo Basin certification scheme concerns three countries for the moment. Maybe there will be an extension because we are discussing with another country. It is not a secret, which is DRC, because some stakeholders there are interested to rejoin the scheme. So currently the scheme is working with three countries, Cameroon, Congo Republic, and Gabon. And as far as the standard setting itself is concerned, we start the standard setting process in June 2019. And the process really start with the recruitment of the project coordinator. And after that, we gone through some steps to reach the final point, which was the submission of our request for the scheme endorsement to PFC. And concerning the steps, the first steps we gone through was the standard setting documents. At the beginning, when launching the process, we draft some documents. And I will mention, let's say, two the most important documents, which are one, the standard setting procedure. That document was drafted to identify all the steps to be followed, and also to clarify the different activities to be made in each step. So it was like a guide for all the process that we've gone through. And also the second important document that we drafted during this step was the stakeholder mapping. So we did different mapping, they say like that, one stakeholder mapping for each country. And those stakeholder mappings were done by the PFC. So each PFC prepare the mapping for the country. And with the support, of course, of the project team. And at the level of the project, we elaborated or we drafted what we call a regional stakeholder mapping, where we identify all the stakeholders who are having or are operating in the different countries at the same time. So for the first step, I can mention those two important documents, even if we draft some other documents like the project proposal and some others. So that is about the first step we're going through. And the second step was the public announcement of the standard setting process launch and the call for interest to stakeholders. And here, based on the stakeholders identified during the first step, we send emails to all the stakeholders that we have identified, the national and the regional stakeholders. And also we did some publications on different websites, on newspapers in the different countries, and also in radio station in each country. And the public announcement has also been published in the ATIBT website, as well as in the PFC Congo website also. And at the same time, we launched the public announcement. We also sent invitations to those stakeholders to express their interest to participate in the standard setting process as member of the working group that we put in place. And working group was the third step in the process. From the expression of interest that we received after the launch of the invitation to the stakeholders, we did a selection. We did an analysis of the expression of interest that we received. And we received, as you can see here, 88 expression of interest from the different stakeholders. And after the analysis of each expression of interest based on some criteria that we have defined, for example, the experience on the certification operations, we came out, after the analysis, we came out with a list of 15 stakeholders and plus four experts that we have selected from the 88 expression of interest that we received. We selected four experts to assist or to support the working group members in the work. And during that period of the creation of the regional working group, we also did an analysis of the comments received from those stakeholders concerning the standard setting procedure. Because I didn't mention it, because when we launched the public announcement and the invitation, we sent some documents attached to the invitation. And among documents, there was the standard setting process in order to receive the comment and maybe adjust or improve the standard setting process. So after the analysis of the comments on the standard setting process, we came out with a new version which have been submitted to the working group members for validation. And that validation have been done during the step who followed that third step. And that step was the regional workshop that we held in Libreville in Gabon with the 16 forum members plus the four experts and two representatives from each PFC, from each country. So we held that first workshop in Gabon, as I said, and we had very, very intensive discussion during a week. And after the week, we came out with the first version of the Congo Basin forest, Congo Basin standard for certification of forest. And maybe it's important also here to mention that during the workshop in Gabon, we discussed the discussion were around the draft of the, let's say, the working documents that have been sent to the forum members before the meeting. It was a kind of baseline for where we started the discussion to reach the point of having the first version of the regional standard. And after that workshop in Gabon, that first workshop, we launched the first public consultation where we submitted the first version of the standard to all the stakeholders involved in forest or interested by forest operation in the Congo Basin. And that first public consultation lasted for 60 days. And at the end of the process of public consultation, we received 191 comments from different stakeholders. And we did an analysis of the comments received, the comments on the requirements, the comments that we received. We did an analysis and some proposition of change of modification have been done based on some comments that we received. And from there, we came out with the second version, a new version of the regional standard. And after that, we organized a panel test, a test of the regional standard to evaluate, to appreciate the, how can I say, the reliability of those requirements to the reality or to the context of logging operations in Congo Basin. And the test was done by two auditors, very experienced in audit certification, sustainable for the certification audit in the different countries in the Congo Basin. And after the pilot test, we received recommendations as well as comments from the auditors. And from there, we had another analysis, another we had other discussions internally and with the working group members to validate the proposition of modification which have been elaborated or done after the pilot test. And from there, we moved to the second public consultation, which lasted 35 days. And during that second public consultation, we received 113 comments. And once again, we gone through the same process like during the first public consultation. And we came out with a new version of the standard. And it is that version which have been submitted to the final workshop of the forum members in last October. And here I would like to mention that due to the restrictions imposed by the management of the COVID-19 in the different countries, we organized that final workshop through a video conference. And in each country, we organized things so that in each country, we had one group meeting somewhere to participate with the other groups in the other countries in that video conference. And we discuss that last version of the standard during 2 days. And after the 2 days, we came out with the what I can call for the moment, while waiting for the assessment of PFC, we came out with the final version of the regional standard. And that final version was submitted for approval to ATIBT, which is the standardizing body for the process that we are doing. And also we submitted the last version to the PFC for adoption by the General Assembly of each PFC. And all those adoption or validations have been done in December. And in the same December, we submitted our request for endorsement to PFC International. Now we are waiting for the result of the assessment and see if it will be necessary to implement the other steps which have been identified in the standard setting procedure. Now, a point which to me, it's important to mention because it is linked to the standard that we are going to use for logging operation certification in Congo Basin. We prepared a regional standard, but at the same time, even if more of the laws governing logging operations in the country are similar, but there are some specificity, mainly on the field where logging operations are taking place. For example, to elaborate a management plan in Cameroon, you can go through the same steps like in Gabon or in Congo Republic or DRC, but some documents which are issued by the administration, for example, after the approval, those documents can have different names. And we thought that, or let's say we agree with the PFC and all the stakeholders, even the working group, we agree that it is necessary to add something else to the regional standard. The requirements of the regional standard will not be modified, but we will add what we call the verifiers to ease the job of the auditors once on the field. Because without doing that, we think that maybe we can experience or we can face some difficulties during the implementation phase of the requirements of the regional standard. So to prepare those guides, we call them national interpretive guide, and to prepare those guides, the first thing we did was to agree on a kind of guidance document, which will guide the elaboration of those national interpretive guides. So the guidance document was prepared last year. We discussed it with the national PFC and the project team, and we agree on the approach to be implemented as well as on the objectives of those guides. And the development of the guide, national guide itself, will start this year. And we think that maybe by June, July of this year, we'll have those national interpretive guide on place. And as I mentioned before, those documents will be closely prepared with the national PFC. And now, concerning the system, the certification system itself, I would say that the certification system is made of two main components. And here we have the first component with the different standards, because apart from the forest standard that we prepare and that I just present the process, we also adopted some standards from PFC International as it is required on in this kind of process. And so in terms of standard, we have the forest standard, chain of custody standard, and some standard concerning the CBEs, which are going to do the certification operation for logging companies. And also, the other component is the procedure aspect. We have prepared some procedures to manage the system. And we have four main procedures that we have prepared. As you can see on the table here, we have a handling of complaint, procedures for the notification, for the notification of CBEs, and also another procedure concerning the using of the logos and those things. And finally, to manage the system that we are going to put in place, we are still discussing a structure that can be which can be implemented. But for now, where we are with the discussion with the national PFC now, The structure looks like what you can see here. We have the three national PFC who are the owners of the scheme. And we are thinking that maybe it can be important to have a kind of regional secretary who can do, how can I say, the management, who can be in charge of the management of the system administratively, I mean, on the behalf of the three PFC. Of course, he will closely work with the three PFC, who, as I mentioned, are the real owner of the certification scheme that we are preparing. So, in terms of summary of the PFC Congo Basin certification system process that we're going through, that's what I can say. And if there are questions, we can answer the question. Thank you very much for your attention. Hello? Hello?
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, German, for the detailed presentation. And now I would like to open the floor. Please, German, can you stop sharing your screen, please?
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Okay, it's done.
Thank you very much. Now, after this presentation, we are open the floor for questions. Please, as I mentioned, since it's a very large scale regional scheme with a very wide set of documentation available for public consultation, I would ask for the participants to focus on clarifications questions until the time available. Please use the raise hand option from the reactions. Please introduce yourself and then ask your question for Germain Yenné, the project coordinator. I think, German, your presentation was so clear and detailed that we don't have any questions for the moment, but I would like to ask again if anybody has a question regarding the Pan-African certification system for the Congo Basin. It seems that everything was covered by you, German, in the presentation. And with this, I would like to thank you once again for taking the time, everyone, for joining us for this today's webinar. And again, a kind reminder, if you're interested in the system and if you'd like to know more, please visit the PEFC website and check the documentation of the PAFC available for your comments until 1st of April. And with this, I would like to close the webinar, unless there is one